Okay, hello and good evening to all of you. Today I would like to discuss one of the current related issue. You must know there is a place called Juku Valley. This Juku Valley is a valley where you can find different kind of flowers. One of the most beautiful place inside Nagaland. However, it is you can say connects the Nagaland and Manipur. It is located in between Nagaland and Manipur. The meaning of Juku, you know, Juku, it does mean that dullness and sorrow. Why? Because the Angami community, the Angami tribal, you know, it lives in Nagaland. So they found that this Juku Valley, this place, is not good in terms of agriculture. Because the kind of geography was there, it was not easily harvested area. So they called that, yes, this area is beautiful, but this beauty is not going to fulfill our stomach. You know, because unless we perform agriculture, how we can run our livelihood? So they told that this Juku Valley, although it is one of the most beautiful place inside Nagaland, but it is the symbol of dullness and sorrowness. Anyway, this Juku Valley, if you go in Manipur, a lake is there that is called, Lomjo National Park. And this is located inside district Vishnupur, inside Manipur. And this is the world's first floating national park, which is located inside Manipur. It is famous for its Phumadi. Phumadi means, you know, it's a grass like structure. So, people use for their livelihood this Phumadi. So, what actually I mean to tell you that it is also one of the most beautiful place inside Manipur, this floating national park in the world, the first floating national park. You know, this Loktak Lake. Now, in the same way, in Mizoram, there is a waterfall. And in Mizoram's biggest uninterrupted waterfall, its name is Tawang something, because the name is very much close to their language, so sometimes it becomes very difficult in order to pronounce it, but you might be knowing about it. So, actually, why I am telling about this Manipur, Nagaland and Mizoram, because these beautiful places cannot be seen very easily unless you require some sort of permission from the government of Nagaland, Manipur and this Mizoram, because these are the states, those are internationally connected, internationally border connected, and most of the northeastern states are, you know, means some sort of disturbance is also going. The armed force is, however, in recently, I think from Meghalaya, it has been lifted. But what I mean to tell you that these people, these northeastern people, they have their own culture, they have their own identity. So what happens, they need a kind of special protection. So what happened, that's why the concept of inner line permit is there. That's why the concept called restricted area permit is there. And that's why the concept called protected area permit is there. However, this restricted area permit is related with the Andaman and Nicobar and some part of Sikkim. But what I mean to tell you that these are some sort of, you can say, blockade. you know, no any Tom, Dick and Harry kind of person can go and enter inside these states without having any sort of permission, prior permission. So these are, you know, a kind of, you can say, entry ticket. These are the, you can say, a sort of passport which require to enter in these areas. Why it came why it came into news? Because recently Home Ministry has decided that we are going to lift this PAP, protected area permit. This PAP is related with Nagaland, Manipur and Mizoram. Means if any foreigner, let me tell you that this PAP is not related with the Indian resident. This is related with the foreigners, the alien people. So if any alien, if any foreigners want to visit the Manipur, the Nagaland and Mizoram, then what used to happen that they had to attend this protected area permit. Unless they are getting this protected area permit, they cannot enter inside Manipur, Mizoram and Nagaland. So what happened, the Home Ministry recently from the 1st of April has planned to do that. We are going to lift this ban for next 6 years, at least for next 6 years. So let me tell you that this act is more than 60 years old. It was brought in the year 1958. So, you know, means the Home Ministry had decided, that's why it came into news. The what you need to know about it, that it is not related with the Indian citizen, it is not related with the Indian residents, it is mainly for the foreigners. It is the entry gate of the foreigners. So you can say, if this protected area permit has been removed, so foreigners can easily come, the tourism can easily promote it. However, there are some other circumstances can be, but one thing is very clear, that if you are not getting any sort of hurdles, so definitely I think you can reach easily and you can be frequent most of the time. We don't go inside Jammu and Kashmir because, you know, means I think attaining a SIM card in Jammu and Kashmir is more tougher. You know what I want to tell you. So you know, this protected area permit has been, you can say, lifted by the Home Ministry, and the foreigners can easily go inside these places, those were related with this protected area permit. These are other terms which we need to know. That is the inner line permit. Let me tell you that it is related with the foreign nationals, but this one, the inner line permit, it is for the Indian residents. You know, so and let me tell you one more thing. You know, I was watching a video, and what I saw, that one person, one foreign national, he has to wait for more than 17 days to get this protected area permit, I think inside Nagaland. You know, he had to visit time and time again continuously for 17 days. Finally, he could achieve this PAP or not. But the thing is this, he had to waste his 17 days in order to acquire this protected area permit. So if it has been lifted, so definitely I think it has become very easy, very convenient to visit these, one of the most beautiful places, you can, the second heaven, if anywhere is located only next to Jammu and Kashmir, that is the northeastern state, the seven sisters of our country. So this inner line permit is related with the Indian resident. The acquire the means you know, you can, it can be easily achieved, it can be easily acquired in comparison to the PAP. And this is also mainly related with the northeastern states. So as I have told you that these are some sensitive areas. So what happens, the government decided that we need to protect their culture, their identity. That's why the inner line permit was brought, so that the Indian residents, they could not create some sort of disturbance, especially in these kinds of areas. So the ILP, the inner line permit, is related with the Indian resident, and this PAP is related with the foreign nationals. Okay, so it sometimes gets some sort of change, that from this place it has been removed, or from this place, so this ILP can be received by the posts. Those are located, let's say you want to visit Manipur. So what happened if you are getting any check post? So sometimes you can get this ILP, or the Home Ministry is the ultimate authority of it. Okay, so in the same way, what is the restricted area permit? This restricted area permit, I think you might remember the case what happened, 5 or 6 years back with the Jarwa community. It's a very famous case related with the Jarwa community, which lives inside Jammu and Kashmir. Some foreigners came and they wanted to exploit. They were disturbing their life. They were disturbing the lives of these tribals. They were taking the photographs and providing some food material. So it was not, it was a violation of law, because you cannot go and disturb these communities. So what I mean to tell you that this RAP is the restricted area permit, and it is also related with the foreign nationals. The only difference between the PAP and RAP is this, that RAP is mainly concentrated, it is mainly affiliated or related with the Andaman and Nicobar and some part of Sikkim. However, the PAP covers most of the our northeastern states. So this RAP is for the foreign nationals, and mainly related with the Andaman and Nicobar and some part of Sikkim. The way it was brought in the year 1958, it was brought in the year 1968. Okay, 1968. Let me tell you that the whatever the news, the current information is related with the PAP only. But these were the concepts which were very much related with the PAP. So that's why I discussed. Otherwise, this was given, and the government has only lifted this PAP, not the RAP. There is no any news, with respect to the RAP or this ILP. The thing is this, that this was seeming more similar, might be this can be asked. So this was from my side. Thank you very much.